think I hitchhiked the right car. Okay, I roll down your window.
Yeah. Jacksonville National Cemetery. Since the time of our founding fathers, our nation has honored her fallen patriots at services much like this one. These hallowed marble stones that surround us stand as solemn memorials to the men and women who answered our nation's call to serve. Some served but a few years. Some served many years. Some made the ultimate sacrifice, but each one served so that we may have the freedom we all enjoy to this day. Today we have gathered to remember and honor one of our nation's heroes. Today we honor Staff Sergeant Election Mary Chan. Let's pray. Almighty God, whose days are without end, whose mercies cannot be numbered, and whose love is an everlasting love, we have gathered today for this purpose, to honor the memory of Election Chan. We give you thanks for the gift of life and for the ability to remember. To remember not only our own lives, but also to remember the lives lived by those we love, who have preceded us in death. Please grant us clarity of mind. Please flood our thoughts and imaginations with fond memories of Election. In addition, I pray that Election's loved ones will encounter your presence and experience your peace, a peace that surpasses understanding, even amidst the most difficult and sorrowful seasons of life. Please send your spirit to answer this prayer and meet us in this, our hour of need. Amen. Many of us here are mourning what feels like two losses. The 27 years of life that Election lived, and the many potential years of life yet to be lived, both of which are gone. As the enlisted executive officer with the 374th Mission Support Group at Yokota Air Base, Japan, Sergeant Chan was widely known, greatly leaned on, and tremendously loved. As a matter of fact, I was made known of her most recent recognition as the Airlifter of the Week by the 374th Airlift Wing, quite the NCO. Johnson, Rorn, Thim, family, and friends, my heart ached at the news of Election's passing. You have my deepest condolences. You have my continued prayers. Many of us at a time like this, we lean on family, we lean on friends, and most certainly we lean on our faith. Some 3,000 years ago in ancient Israel lived a man known as King David. To this day, King David is Israel's most beloved king. But David was not always a king. As a young lad, David was simply a young shepherd boy who watched over his father's flock of sheep. In time, he grew to love those sheep. And then it happened. David recognized a correlation. The way a shepherd loves his sheep is the same way God loves his people. So, David wrote a song in which he imagines himself as the sheep and God as his shepherd. Today we know that song as the 23rd Psalm. As we gather in this hallowed ground, in the shadow of death, I'd like to recall the words of that beloved song. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul, and he leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Those are the words of our King David. King David had a son named Solomon who also served as Israel's king. As we gather together, I'd like to share a few words by Solomon in the book of Ecclesiastes. He wrote, "To everything there is a season, and a time for every purpose under heaven, a time to be born, and a time to die, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time of war, and a time of peace. God has made everything beautiful in its time." Would you pray with me? Lord, please look down in compassion on those whose joy has been turned into mourning because of Election's departure. Do not leave my friends comfortless. Sustain them now and in the days to come with fond memories and the power of hope. My friends, may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen. Amen. In Washington, D.C., there is a monument to a great American hero. The inscription thereon reads, "In life he honored the flag. In death, the flag shall honor him." Election honored the flag with her service to our nation. Now it's our privilege to present our nation's flag in honor of Election Chan, Staff Sergeant, United States Air Force.
Family, please rise for the rendering of military honors.
It will be fine of weapons, so prepare yourself.
Resist!
Force in a great formation. Please accept this flag as a symbol of our appreciation for your wife's honorable and faithful service.
Who can I...